Good morning, children. Happy morning. Have a nice day. I am from Mahatma Gandhi Vidyalaya School. I am your social teacher. I am Mrs. Nandini. I know you are all excited to listen the lesson. Before going to the lesson, I will tell you a thought. Thought for the day. Being happy is a very personal thing and it really has nothing to do with anyone else. If you want to be happy, you must have internal peace. If you have peace, then you will be happy. If you don't have peace, then nothing will make you happy. So, I repeat the thought once again. Being happy is a very personal thing and it really has nothing to do with anyone else. Today, I am going to continue the lesson which I took in the last class. I am going to take the history lesson, how, when and where. Now, I will ask you some questions. We will do recapitulation. Some questions I will ask you. The first question, what is history? History is about changes that occur time. It is about finding out how things were in the past and how things have changed. Again, I repeat, history is about changes that occur time. It's about finding out how things were in the past and how things have changed. So here we compare present and past. So history is about the changes that occurred time. It is about finding out how things were in the past and how things have changed. When we compare present and past, we refer time. We use the words before and after. So we use the words before and after. These words are used in history. Now, what is BC? BC is before Christ. Expand AD. AD means Anno Domini. Now, next question. What is colonization? The subjugation of one country by another leads to political, economical, social and cultural changes is known as colonization. It means the suppression of one country by another. For example, British suppressed India. So the country India have political, economical, social and cultural changes. Again, I repeat, the subjugation of one country by another leads to political, economic, social and cultural changes is known as colonization. Historians use British official records to study 250 years of Indian history. British believed the act of writing important. Every instructions, policy, plan, agreement, decision and investigation had to be clearly written. Now where are these documents preserved? British preserved the documents in the following places. The village tahsildar office, the collectorate, the commissioner's office, the provincial secretariat, the law courts, archives and museums. Again, I repeat, British preserved the documents in the village tahsildar's office, the collectorate, the commissioner's office, the provincial secretariat, the law courts, archives and museums. Now, we come for today's portion. In villages, revenue survey is done to know the topography, the soil quality, the flora, the fauna, the local histories and the cropping pattern. We are seeing the records. Other than the records, in villages, revenue surveys are done. So, the revenue surveys are done to know the topography, the soil quality, the flora and the fauna, the local history and the cropping pattern. Here topography means land structure, whether it's a mountain or hill or plain. And the soil quality means the quality of soil, whether it's a fertile soil or not. And then the flora. Flora means plant kingdom, The fauna means animal kingdom. And the local history, history is about the local area. And the cropping pattern, that is the agriculture of that region. All these things were done by the survey. All these things were noted during the survey. And they were all clearly drawn as a map. And the records were maintained clearly. So they were all done by the Survey of India. Even now the survey department does the surveying. These surveys are very, very helpful for the Britishers to know about the India. They were done in a scientific manner. See, a picture is shown. Mapping and survey operations in progress in Bengal. And here, see how the instruments were used in surveys are placed in the foreground to show the scientific nature of the project. Each and every area, the British officials and the British persons gone and done with so much care so that it will be helpful for them to study about the India. Now we come to see what is surveying. Usually you heard the word surveying in marketing, market surveying. That is, if you gone to purchase any product in the shop, that the company person will come and ask you questions related to the product. For example, if you purchase a cool drink, sometimes the cool drink company person comes and asks you about the cool drink, the color of the cool drink, the taste, whether you like or not, all these things. By your answer, they understand about their product. They rectify the mistakes. But here the surveying means land surveying. Here the surveying or the land surveying is a technique, profession, art and science of determining the terrestrial or three-dimensional positions of points and the distance and angles between them. Surveying has been an element in the development of human environment since the beginning of recorded history. So here the surveying means surveying of the land areas and the other things in the land. Other than surveying, census recording also done. At the end of the 19th century, census operations were held every 10 years. It gives number of people in all provinces, information on caste, religion and occupation. So what is census? A census is an official enumeration of population done periodically. In India, the first census was held in the year 1872. The first complete census, however, was taken in the year 1881. Since then, census have been held regularly every 10th year. So the census record is very helpful to do planning. So the British needed this record to know about the population of India. They will give the information on caste, religion, occupation. Even today, census recordings are done. Once in 10 years, it will be done. We are having the divisions like states, districts, etc. Similarly, those days, the British India have provinces. So today also, census operations were done once in every 10 years. Now next we are going for the other thing, that is other surveys. Botanical survey, zoological survey, archaeological survey, anthropological survey and forest survey. Botanical survey means surveying, that is analyzing about the plant specimens. And zoological survey means analyzing about the animals. Anthropological survey, archaeological survey and forest survey are the other surveys. Archaeological survey, archaeology means the study of human activity through the recovery and analysis of material culture, that is from the earth, digging the earth and they are getting material from the earth. Those things say about the history of India or history of our country, how the people lived in ancient days and all. So the survey done based for that is known as archaeological survey. Anthropology means the scientific study of human behavior and their society. So the survey based on that is known as anthropological survey. Forest survey is a survey for the forest, for the identification of forest area. Now, there is a picture showing a custard apple plant, 1770s. Botanical gardens and natural history museums established by the British collected plant specimens and information about their uses. Local artists were asked to draw pictures of these specimens. Historians are now looking at the way such information was gathered and what this information reveals about the nature of colonialism. Okay, other than these sources, we have some other sources also there. whatever we are seeing, the sources are all official sources. Those sources say only the positive side of the British. But other than that, we had got some extra sources, diaries of people, accounts of pilgrims and travelers, autobiographies of important personality, popular booklets in local bazaars. See, I think in your house, you would have seen some people writing diaries. Similarly, those days also, people written diaries. So the diaries of people we got and we preserved that. Diaries of people, accounts of pilgrims and travelers. Travelers come to our country and they return something. And autobiographies of important personalities. That is, important people like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru and all. Our Mahatma Gandhi, our Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and all written autobiographies. And then popular booklets in local bazaars. So these are all the sources helpful for us to know about our country. How the people lived in our country. And the newspaper reports. Reports of the newspaper also vary. Sometimes one newspaper will give focus on one thing. Sometimes the focus is on different. So here one report. In 1946, the colonial government in India was trying to put down a mutiny that broke out on the ships of the Royal Indian Navy. And they had given a sample of the kind of reports the Home Department got from different dockyards. It's from Bombay and Karachi. And next, one more report, not fit for human consumption. This is also from 1946. And this is about the police strike. More than 2000 policemen in Delhi refused to take their food on Thursday morning because they are protesting against the low salary and the poor quality of food. And after the printing came, people started to print books. So their feelings were all written and printed. The printing was very helpful to transform the life of people. It changed the history. It changed the history of our country as well as history of the world. So printing got an important position in the history. The first printed book is Bible. And printing spreads the feelings of our leaders, our reformers, poets, novelists, and the various issues in newspapers were debated. So printing spread the feelings of our leaders. Our leaders like our father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, all their feelings are all written and they were printed. And the reformers like our Rajaram Mohan Roy and of course our father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, their feelings also written in the papers. And the poets and the novelists who are all written novels about the country's freedom, that and all came in the books. And various issues in newspapers were debated. Various issues in newspaper were debated. So the printing is helpful to show the feelings. And now we are going to see the assignment. Answer the following. First question, expand AD and BC. Second word, what is history? Third word, define colonization. Fourth one, list of the different types of surveys. Fifth one, where did the British preserve their written documents? I hope you understood the lesson. Thank you, children. Thank you.